गुड इवनिंग डॉक्टर्स, वेलकम अगेन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्लिनिकल साइंसेज MCQs। विच ऑफ दिस कुड कॉज अ रिड्यूस ट्रांसफर फैक्टर? सो द रिड्यूस ट्रांसफर फैक्टर इज कॉज्ड बाय एम्फाइसीमा। रिड्यूस ट्रांसफर फैक्टर इंक्लूड्स एक्यूट अस्थमा, पल्मोनरी एम्बोलिज्म, पल्मोनरी इडीमा, पल्मोनरी फाइब्रोसिस, न्यूमोथोरेक्स एंड एनीमिया। These are reduced transfer factor. Let's see, pulmonary fibrosis, pulmonary edema, pneumothorax, pulmonary embolism, anemia and acute asthma and emphysema. These are the causes of reduced transfer factor. Hemispatial neglect is usually associated with lesion to which region of the brain? This mainly involves the region of right parietal lobe. Right parietal lobe. This clinical sign usually arises from lesions to the right parietal lobe in most left dominant brains. The left spatial sensory information is processed only by the right cerebral hemisphere, predominantly the parietal lobe. Okay. A couple with a 3-year-old daughter who has Turner syndrome have come to the pediatric clinic. They want to discuss their daughter's prognosis with respect to both fertility and likely morbidity during the course of her life. Which of the following represents the commonest cause of death in individual with Turner syndrome? So you can pause this video and think the single best answer. So the single best answer is aortic aneurysm rupture. Aortic aneurysm rupture. Evidence on Turner syndrome mortality comes from cohort study from the UK, which has enrolled over 3,400 women with the condition. Circulatory disease accounted for 41% of excess death associated with Turner syndrome. Of these, the SMR for aortic aneurysm was about 20, whereas for aortic valve disease, it has been estimated 17.9. Diabetes and inflammatory colitis are also more common in Turner syndrome. Okay, let's discuss more. With regard to lung function testing, which of the following is likely to cause an increased transfer factor? So we know decreased transfer factor like pulmonary fibrosis, acute asthma, pulmonary edema, emphysema. So exercise is the increased transfer factor. Okay. You review a 22-year-old man who complains of a lump in his scrotum. He says it is painful and has been slowly increasing in size over the past 6-9 months. On examination, he has left testicular mass. You wonder if he may have seminoma. Which of the following tumor marker is likely to be raised? So pause this video and think which one is the best answer here. So the best answer is alkaline phosphatase, placental alkaline phosphatase. Okay, C19 for pancreatic carcinoma. Okay, 19.9. 43-year-old landscape gardener complains of increasing shortness of breath. His pulmonary function test shows a low FEV1 and normal gas transfer factor. Which is the most likely diagnosis? Of the most likely diagnosis here is asthma. Let's discuss. C15/3 and 27/29 are associated with breast disease, as in HER2. Placental alkaline phosphate is elevated in pregnancy, seminoma, and smoking. CA125 is a raised in carcinoma of ovary. CA19-9 is raised in pancreatic and colorectal cancer. Okay. Asthma, low FEV1 can give normal gas transfer. Acute asthma can give the reduced transfer factor, whereas convalescent asthma can give increased transfer factor. Okay. What is the main function of the mitochondria? Mitochondria, the main function is to produce ATP as cell energy source. Okay. You are taking a family history in clinic and the patient reports a few conditions that he thinks may have occurred in his relatives. Which of the following condition is inherited in autosomal recessive manner? That is, hemochromatosis is an autosomal recessive disorder. Okay. What is the mechanism action of abatacept? That is cytotoxic T lymphocyte antigen 4 CTLA4 homologue. Okay. You carry out a blood gas on a patient who has just been admitted to the medical admission unit. These are the results. The patient is on room air, pH 7.28, PCO2 3, PO2 12, SCO3 18. Which of the following cause is most likely? So the best answer here is acute infective diarrhea, example cholera. Yeah, acute diarrhea can cause metabolic acidosis as seen here due to loss of bicarbonate in diarrheal fluid. pH is low, PCO2 is also low. Thus suggests some element of respiratory compensation by hyperventilation. COPD causes a respiratory acidosis, raised PCO2. So guys, I hope till here it's very much clear for you. If you have any queries, any question, you can ask me. If you're new on my channel, please subscribe it. Thank you. Good day. Goodbye. That's all for today.